off, I think, before I solder them, because they just get in the way. I'm going to mute the sound actually, because I'm still watching the video. I'm watching Z actually. Yeah, I'm sort of watching Z at the moment, so yeah. I'll leave the sound on, but you can always mute me if you want. Yeah, I missed the car seal change thing yesterday, so I'm watching it now. I'm just getting the resistors in first, and then I'm going to start putting the other stuff in afterwards. I found my low value resistor pack, which is what I wanted, and I've got my 10Ks here, which if I can't find any 10Ks, I've got them in here. New ones. There's probably some 10Ks in here, actually. Maybe. Mind you, I ordered them because I'd run out, so probably not. The low value resistors aren't critical, actually. The pull down resistors are not that critical. But I'm trying to keep the values reasonable, about 3.3k pull down, so I don't consume too much power on the circuit. Z sounds like he's ice breaking. Right, what's the next lot? Okay, it's the R10 and the R11. Let's see what I've got here. 2.19. I think these will work for that.
Yeah, a little more.
Ten and 11. Sorry if I woke anybody up. Yeah, I'm here. Shubas. Well, cool, I'd like to watch, but I need to get this circuit built. And I'm watching Z as well, catching up on his video. Yeah, I need to get these resistors in. Definitely need to get these resistors in. And you know what, when I built the previous board, I found out that these legs on these resistors are a little bit mucky, and I had some dry joints. So what I'm having to do is scrape them with my tweezers. And the easiest way to do that is to trim the legs down first, so I can scrape the legs to clean them, because otherwise I'm going to end up with dry joints. I'm going to have dry joints, and I don't want that problem. So R10, R11. Where are we? actually. I can't find it. I'm down here. R10, R11. Yeah, the last thing I need is dry joints. So that's why I'm trimming the legs off first, because then I can get to the part that I'm going to be soldering, and then I can scrape it with my tweezers to clean it. And that's basically why I'm doing that. To clean the legs. Pushing to make sure they don't fall out. Right, that's R10 in. I think this is R11. I hope I've mixed up. But I don't want to make sure I don't get mixed up. Yeah. Yeah, Z sound like you're struggling a bit. Stiff arm. Don't know if I've been sleeping in a funny position. Cramping my shoulder.
I'm pretty sure the seal is in far enough.
Crikey, Z was having such a job with this.
Pretty sure it is not good enough.
I wonder if he actually completed it. Yeah, okay, sure, but you'll get a dog walk. Our clocks went back yesterday by an hour, by the way. I was a bit confused when I looked at my computer clock, because it said that an hour earlier than what my other clocks were saying. I thought, oh, clocks went back last night. So, yeah, you're not going to miss much. I'm just putting the resistors in right now, and I'm going to be soldering this. I'm going to solder the resistors in, then I'm going to be putting the other components in afterwards, because it's, I want to make sure that I've got no dry joints, and plus obviously when you're soldering the other components, they're a lot easier because they stand up more and you can hold them, but yeah. Yeah, you do that, Shubert, because I'm taking my time with this. I really am. I'm really slow. Taking my time on this right now. I'm not rushing. I just want to make sure I get it right. Right, so I need R12 and R13. I think those are the 10K ones. No, they aren't. R12, R13. Those are the 1.8K ones. Right, okay, 1.8K. There should be some lying around in here. That one, 2.7, that's so clear. No, I'm just looking for it. I could use 2.2s actually. They're near enough. I'll think about using them. I'm just going to see if I've got 1.8Ks though.
That camshaft seal is on all the way.
I should have
now
some.
Begin the reassembly.
Alright, let's have a look, see what else I've got in here, because these are all lows. 8.2, 3. Oh, that's a 3K. I don't want that. 8.2. I've got a lot of 8.2s. 5.6. Six point eight. 3.4. I want 1.8K if there is any left. Or 2K will work.
And there's something if you fix a repair being a remote or something. Otherwise, no.
Oh, 1.3s. Oh. 1.3, so it will work too. Yeah, here we go. 1.6K. Ah, that'll work. That's just the job.
Instead of just
2Ks. Put them aside. I might need them as well. 5.1s. 4.3s. Point twos, 3.6s. Yeah, I'm just going to go with the 1.6Ks. They're close enough. They're not that critical. It's between the 4 and 5 junction and the VC182L and VC212L this. That's for the driver's circuit. Actually, I'll probably stick 2Ks in. I think I'd probably stick 2Ks in there, just a little bit higher, and they won't use as much current as well. A little bit less current drive. I don't really need all that current drive anyway. This one looks a bit... Where's this come from? Hope it hasn't fallen out of... I'll just measure that, see what it is. I hope it hasn't fallen out my board. Better not have done. What's this one? Oh, that's really high value. I don't know where that's come from, but I'm definitely not using that one. Okay, so I'm going to use a 2Ks. I've got plenty of 2Ks, you see. I haven't got many 1.6Ks. And obviously, when I need a 1.6, I will be... And a 2.2, actually. That's when you kind of wish you hadn't used it. Right. Okay, so I'll stick 2 2Ks in there. And that is the... R13 and R12.
What I needed was the camshaft seal is a ring that goes inside around the camshaft journal. And what I needed was really a socket big enough to press firmly around the edge of the seal as it went into the groove that was formed by the casting of the block and the journal of the cam. And in lieu of that, I had to work my way around the outer edge, trying to press it in as best I can, but I could only tap it in so far. The camshaft seal and working my way around it. There really was not a whole lot of choice. Like I said, a socket the right size would have been perfect, but not so easy to come by. That's it. Climbing belt is tension.
I wish we didn't have to change our clocks as well. Such annoying.
Yep. Because there are a couple of spots that require an adhesive sealant to fill the little crevices that are formed in the engine block, in the head. And this is a point not in Toyota's favor, I would say. And this is another place where...
It's so much better to cut the wires off first.
And it does.
I don't have legs sticking out everywhere. like my silk screen, it makes life so much easier. Oh, I've got R23. I think that's the 10K. Yeah. R23, R22. Right, I need the 10Ks now. Stick these back in here because I'm pretty near now. I just don't want too much clutter all over the place.
Who's cheating? Where's the new gasket? Corn plate was stuck. The new gasket is already assembled for the valve cover.
It's a struggler. Where's that one? What's this one? Turn my meter off, haven't I? Oh, that's a 1.3. I don't know where I was going to use that. But oh, it's already open. I just better double check these. Make sure they're actually 10Ks and not something anomalous. Wires, flipping wires. Yeah. These are the 10s. I need a lot of these actually. And we need four of these. So I think I'll take two out one side. I need to trim these papers off actually, because this is what pulls them apart. I'll take two out the other side. When you've got the paper sticking out, it pulls the other legs out, so if I trim these off, they won't become homeless. I might as well stick them in there now. Oh, I need to write on them what they are. That would help in future. Okay, that's that done. Note to self, order more 10K resistors. I seem to use a lot of them. And because they're new, these aren't going to be oxidised. No, they're clean. So I'm not going to have dry joint problems with these. The colour coding's a lot better as well. Standard colour coding, brown, black, orange, instead of them horrible 1-2% things with 5 bands on. I don't like those things. So so it's R22, R23. Oh, is it? Yeah, I'll do them first. And oops, jumping around here. R22, where's R23? There it is. I built the damn thing and I still can't remember how. Come out. I'll have to trim these legs off a bit more once they've been soldered. Oh, I'm dropping bloody legs everywhere now. Where's that one gone? I'm missing all of these videos. Anyway, I downloaded it so I can watch it any time I want, really. Where the heck are the other ones? I must have put something else in there. Oh, R16 and R17. Actually, did I put something in there? R16 and R17. I think I've already put something in. Yeah, I did. I actually put... yeah, that's alright. I think I put 9 point... Let's see. I put 9.14k. That's good enough. Oh, that's 9.97. That's all right. So I don't need to use all my 10Ks.
All right. We'll get some cotton swabs.
Stick them in that bag.
Some alcohol and some paper towel. And try to remove the last bit of oil.
Right, so basically all the resistors are in.
Around those corners.
So the diode's next.
Put some sealant on there and throw the valve cover on.
And I'm going to watch a bit of the... My back is killing me. Oh, God. Turn this light up for a bit. It's daylight, sunny outside.
Under it.
You should be able to see fine with even without the light on. Looks like your Z went off as well. Okay, let's get these diodes in. I have a diode on here ready. These are the right ones. I have to get another... I have to get another three of those. I'll go get them now.
She's in the kitchen right now, scraping out the bottom of a large pot that was on top of the stove, cooking down some spaghetti sauce that she was making, and she burnt the hell out of it. And wow. It ruined the whole batch of spaghetti sauce. Pretty bad. So she had to throw it out, and now she's in there with a spatula trying to scrape off the remains at the bottom of the pot.
Oh dear, it's not a good day.
Yeah, both put the waste food.
Z's wife burnt the spaghetti. Maybe I didn't make these holes big enough for the diodes. Never mind. I'll have to maybe make control them a bit more. Just a bit tight, but I'll go in. At least I don't need to bend these legs over. About these diodes is the legs are so soft.
Okay. I just need to wait for that to dry off a little bit. And then I'll put the contact fork and those screws.
Maybe they're a bit too soft.
Time for some vodka and OJ.
I need to...
I get time for some vodka. Yeah, that's it. That's good.
My holes are a little bit tight, but... I'll go in.
And while I'm waiting for that to dry, I can still put together some of this other stuff. Keep this ball rolling. Keeping the ball rolling, how about those Houston Astros, huh?
These diodes are basically only carrying a signal current, so they're not going to get... They're not going to need replacing. I really could have done with bigger holes. I really ought to go and drill them out a bit more. But oh, they'll be fine. At least I've got them nice and straight. That one can go up a bit more down.
Astros are up 2-1.
Next they'll be inventing cars that can self-dismantle themselves. That'll be interesting. It sure would. You know what? I need 6 diodes. Oh well, no worries, I'll get some more. I forgot there's actually 6, yeah, because 2 on the output stage as well. Footprint on these is a little bit wider, I think. Some of these holes are actually going to be bigger anyway. This one fits a lot better. Just goes straight in. Ooh, that was nice. I got nice and low voltage drops across these dials as well. In fact, it should even read on the ohms reading. So I should get a reading on ohms as well as on the diode test. So yes, I do. That's really good. Because normally you have to use the diode check to test these diodes. But these are very low voltage drops. Was I measuring across something else? Well, that one's a little bit lower than the other one, actually, for some reason. It's reading 198 ohms, which is very low. There's actually a bit of capacitance across it as well. This diode actually has a bit of a higher reading. That's strange. Let's have a look. Beyond diode reading. 0.156.
Maximum cut.
0.148. Hmm, that's interesting. That diode's a bit high. These diodes are not very well balanced. They aren't very well balanced, so I'll probably stick that higher value one on the output stage because it's much higher voltage there anyway. Yeah, I should have measured these first actually to find out the pair them up, because they're not exactly very well paired. I'm going to get that bag. For this particular part of the circuit, it really needs to be well balanced. And I never thought that these would be that far out. I'm just going to measure these. I've got everything that's left. Can't get my hand out now. Let's measure them and find the best pairs. I could stick some of them in the output stage, which isn't critical. Could be because of temperature as well. By touching them, it warms them up. So without touching these, let's measure them. Ohms. That one's reading over limit. Obviously, because I've been touching on my fingers, that's probably why. I need to flip this one around. I'll turn them all around the right way so that I don't have to keep changing my leads around. Can't see the stripe on that one. Very well.
With your head. And I asked his advice on which type of adhesive to use for this application.
All right, that's
I'll
a
definitely get the gray. A lot of places recommend the black. But
yeah, it must be because I was touching them with heat. I'd warm them up.
Black is hard. Gray stays flat.
Well, that reads 192 on DC ohms. That's over limit. That's 193, so I'm going to put that one. Where's that 1921? That's that one. So stick that one with that one, because it's nicely matched with that one. Over limit. All these are over limit because I have to put them on diode test, which is what you normally do. So these are actually more conducting, these two. So I think I'll stick these in there and swap these out and put them over the output, because the output's got higher voltage across it anyway. So I'm on diode check now. That's 0.164, 0.188, 0.160. So that's closer to that one.
Hopefully, this is the end of my
0.188. Oh, 0.167. 0.199. 0.166. So, hang on, there's another one close to that. 168, where is it? 0.167. That one's actually a lot closer to that one. 166, 167. These two are a good match. 0.199, 0.188, 0.164. So that's actually close to those. 0.164. It's close to these. 168, 166, 164. It's 199, 189. God, these are miles out. 0.160. 0.152, 0.151. These are very close. And what's in here? 0.151, 0.158. That's not far off. What are these over here that I had a job getting in? 0.149, 0.155. They're not far off. They're close enough, I think. But I think I think I'll put these on the output stage. And they come out quite easily. Trying to get my everything balanced really if I can. So if I stick this on the output stage, the leg should fit straight in the hole. It's going to be a little bit tricky though, because I've cut the legs off now. Yeah, they're going in. Right, that's that one here. Right, so these are on the output stage where it's not going to make a lot of difference because the voltage is higher there. Those are fitted in nicely. And I'll put these matched ones in down here.
I'll tighten these up later, but I know that should do.
I need to put these, tape these so that I know which are matched. It's always worth knowing where they should have thought. Quite get that right. Huh, slightly off now. Never mind, still works. Yeah, I like to get them centered if I can. I'm fussy. And these legs are very soft and malleable. That's a bit too short now. Ouch! Oh, sharp.
Egon. Egon Ellen.
I haven't got these legs spaced out properly now. This is typical. When you get fussy.
What, the mouse running across the floor? Hubris.
Hubris, are you back? I heard someone talk. I don't know if it's Hubris, but I'll go and check the chat, I suppose. Check, see if that is right. I need more light because it's getting dark. Something going in and out. No, that other one wants to be a bit longer. I'm not worried, the legs will not fall off because it's very malleable, very soft copper. Okay, I think that's better. Anything? No, it's not. I haven't got it right yet. Shit. Okay, I'm just going to start again with this. I have not got my legs right. I know I get them bang on, but it's because I'm not... I need to measure it. That one. It's because there's a kink in this one, it's throwing me out. Right, that's better. I'm get that lined up. Bend it. Okay, that should do it. Yeah, oh well, it's more the other way now. Bloody hell, it'll have to do. It'll have to do. I'm not buggering about with this thing anymore. So these diodes are quite closely matched, so I think
I'm never going to come clean. I have to trim them all the way back.
Let me just double check and see if these are all the matched ones, because if they are, I'm going to... put them all in a group. One's not. That one's reading quite high for some reason. Anyway, the others are missing silliness, so I'll just have a look at the chat. Uh, Oh, it's Abbey Room. I'm still building it, adhering. I'm just matching my diodes up right now. These actually are, they're all really slightly different because they're not matched pairs, but these are pretty close, so I'm going to put some captain tape on these so that I know that they're quite closely matched. The rest of them are kind of all over, not far off each other, but it's just that in future when I build another board, it's handy to know which groups are matched closest to each other. So I'll stick these back in the bag if I can find it. I need to colour code. These are not very well matched, so I'm going to stick a red line down. I'll know next time when I see them. Bottom. I'll have to order bigger batches of these because the bigger the batch you get, the more chances you have of pairing them up. They are good diodes, but you've got to basically match pair them yourself. You know, if you want an equally balanced oscillation circuit, it's handy to do that. Anyway, I've got all my diodes in. And my resistors, except the pretension. I'm going to solder these lot. I'm going to solder these before I put the rest of the parts in the board, though. I'll probably solder the IC socket in as well because that's low profile. When you get low profile things in, you can put it on something like a piece of sponge like this, press it down to hold them in place while you're soldering stuff. And that's what I like to do, that's why I like to do the resistors and the diodes first. Because you can press everything down while you're soldering it and it doesn't fall out. Shubas went for dog walk, I think. I don't know if you're watching me, are you? Do I have to type an answer, or did you hear what I said? Maybe it's a good time to roll the dice now Shubas isn't around. Ooh, it's my lucky day. I need more coffee because this is going cold. Okay, well I'm kind of watching Z at the same time. I downloaded Z's videos, so I'm sort of watching Z at the same time. So his valve gasket thingamajig, and it sounds like he's half dead by the sounds of it. I hope, and I think big fingers crossed, I hope that he actually does his non-magnetostriction today, because he said something about being tired because of a long bike ride he did, so I bet today is going to be aching all over, especially if he's been leaning over that car all day, well, for 4 hours. So let's hope he does. Let's hope he does make it into the workshop. Oh, are you going to try a big number now? Yeah, he's not good at all. Well, okay, we'll try 100. Ooh! Not bad. Yeah, it is. My lucky day. I'm really taking my time actually with this board. You probably noticed. I just wanted to do it nice. I wanted to do a neat job of it, and I've got my slots cut out for mounting a heatsink on when I get around to that, which I'm probably going to have to make the heatsink at some point, because look, I've got holes going through there, look. And there. So, the heatsink would it would be an L bracket basically going around. But, yeah. It's a lot easier to cut the slots when you've got no components in there. So I decided to do it first. And this IC socket is gold plated insert, by the way. This is not a cheap IC socket. It's I'll go back to the cam. Oh. This IC socket, the, I can see it. Oh, it's flipping light. Let me just turn the light off. It's too bright. They've got gold inserts or something. A friend of mine gave me these IC sockets some years ago. I took two of the pins out because they were for the compensation, and I don't need them. And because there was one pin missing anyway, so I thought, well, I'll balance it out and take the other pin out. It's hard to see really because of the light reflecting on it. The convoluted socket. Getting zoomed in even more now. It's hard to do this on a camera. You can't really see the gold plated, can you? You can't really see it. I don't know why. The light, probably. It just means that there's going to be less noise. They're usually used for audio sockets, really. Right, so he's probably going to start it up today at some point then to test it to make sure it's not leaking.
Oh shit. I sneaked this in here.
I don't know how long my live stream's been going. I need to. An hour 39 minutes. Yeah, thanks for doing, yeah, it's coming out quite well. Actually, I'll take a scan of it on the scanner. I don't know if it'll work too well though with the components on there, because the camera is crap. I'll try and scan it, but it'll be a little bit blurry. I can't scan it once it's got the big tall transistors on, but I'll try and scan it while it's like this, actually. I'll just put it in the printer and see if I can scan.
I still need to take that belt off.
It might look blurry though, because the scan bed is everything that will be in focus will be touching the bed, but everything that's further away will be blurred a bit probably. Yeah, the background of the circuit board is out of focus, but you can actually see the IC pins pretty well on here. I'll save that and all. PNG, where the hell's PNG gone? My eyes are playing tricks on me again. Oh, there it is. Hang on. Yeah, I don't expect too much with this photo scan, but at least you can see it's a bit blurry on the background of the actual circuit board, because that's because of the elevation. But at least you can read the diodes, almost read the resistor values as well. I don't like these resistors, but they're very hard, actually. I just, most of them are hard to read. I think I need to down-res this. I think it's too big. I'm going to down resolution it a little bit, I think. Mean, 70%. Yeah, he's probably going to have a lie-in. I don't know how big this pile is. Let me find out. How big is it? Oh, it's 3.43 megabytes. Oh, I need to make it a bit smaller than that. Resize. Another 70%. Save. Now, how big is it now? 1.55 megabytes. That's good enough.
No way.
It's just all the space it's using up on the FTP. I've just got to keep my file sizes down. Find my location in the text file. Woof woof. Yeah, like I say, my scanner's not very good at focusing on stuff. When it's elevated by a few millimeters, it just blurs it out. But you can read the values on the resistors. Yeah, quite a few to go yet. Yeah. Thank you. I've already drilled the holes. The holes are already drilled. There's actually some 0.3 millimeter holes on this board. Yeah. Well, I enjoyed designing it. It's more fun designing something than it is actually using the damn thing. Because once you start using it, you kind of take it for granted, don't you? But at some point, once I get the bubble, the square one done, I can use the circuit to drive that as well. Hopefully, and then if I need to up the current on it, I can. But I got my 50 milliamp PTC fuses today. They actually constant 50 milliamps, and they trip at 100 milliamps. So those are these. Tiny little things, resettable fuses. They automatically reset. Are really cool things.
It's so difficult for everyone else.
And they actually go where it says MFR fuse on the board. Probably can't see that actually on that scan. I don't think you can. No, it's blurred out probably. But there's the other early one I scanned actually that's clear without the components at all. Let's see. You'd probably need to look at the, hang on. I'll give you the close up of the board before I put components on it. Hang on. Right, this one is a bit clearer, you're about to read this one. And it's before I put any components on. So you can see it on that one. Read the text on that one. That's the fuse area. It's actually a bit blurry. It just says MFR. That's where that PTC polyfuse thing goes. Right there. in the square box.
Okay. Not right now. Hold that thought, share it with me later.
Yeah, I'm going to make some more coffee. I'll put Z back full screen. Reassemble the alternator belt for the third time now. Third time's the charm, as they say. Yeah, it's probably best if I just save this stream actually and come back when I'm going to do the soldering, because I'm going to have a rest. I'm still waking up. I feel like I'm bit groggy. I haven't had breakfast yet either. I've just been nibbling on crappy biscuits, so. If I don't save the stream, it gets a generic name and it gets lost. Anyway, I've got about, according to this, I've got about another 20 minutes of Z, and then I'm going to start the soldering, so I'll stop the stream. It says there 4 hours 15 minutes, 4 hours 39 when you finish it, so I'm going to stop stream and come back in a bit.